Always been a part of the game. One of the best known enforcers of all time was Montreal's John Ferguson. In the 70s, Dave the Hammer Schultz was the enforcer for the Broad Street Bullies. In recent seasons, Chris Nilan has been resident pugilist at the Montreal Forum, and he doesn't agree with Barry Beck that fighting should be banned in the NHL.
I don't know. I kind of like it to keep it in the game. I think the league has tried a few times. It's always been brought up to the question about fighting, and the league standpoint, just as much as I've heard from John Ziegler, is that it's a great outlet for guys to let out their frustrations, and there's nothing wrong with a good fight one on one.
Doesn't matter which way you beat them in this building, no matter where, no matter when you play a team in your division, you have to be prepared to pay the price. And we paid the price, and I'm sure they paid the price tonight, but we ended up getting the 2 points.
Chrissy, had a hold of Paul Baudelaire, which really isn't a very even fight there, and he kind of took advantage of him there. And so I think our team was pretty stirred up when we saw that.
Miller wants to get after Nylund. He's being held by Kevin Collins. He's pointing at Nylund. This is going to explode.
I was yelling at Nylund. He had a chance to come over and get me because nobody was on him. And I wanted him, hopefully, to come over to me because the ref wouldn't let me go at all. And he was loose running around after he hit Paul Baudelaire. So what I was just trying to do is entice him to come over, and all but the Collins would let us go if he'd came over because it would have been a mismatch.
Nylund. Oh, Nylund took a swing at Lisbon.
It looked like he was going to do something. When he started coming to the bench, I think he was smiling at somebody or Terry or somebody looking, he was proud of himself or something. I'm not sure quite what.
Well, it's obvious. Every time I cross there, I either get hit with beer or someone's yapping at me from the bench. I mean, I got to go through there a few times, in my career. And, I'm not going to. I don't like to put up with a lot, and it's like other guys. When O'Reilly played, he didn't like putting up with too much either.
Well, this will clear the benches. Here we go. Harry O'Reilly trying to hold off Mike McPhee and Patrick Roy.
Just out of an instinctual reaction, when there's a gathering like that, if everybody just holds somebody out of it, it doesn't get quite as messy.
This thing has spilled out into the hallway between the dressing rooms. This is unbelievable.
I've never seen anything like this with 30 fans, 10 cops, and all the Montreal guys, coming out of the locker rooms, throwing punches at everybody, and then ducking back in.
We didn't show you the fight to glamorize it, but as Jay Miller points out, fighting is a part of hockey. Hockey is a game of passion.
This is unbelievable. Now, what you're looking at is the main event, but that Miller-Mealy duel is still going. Now they broke that one up. Boy, this is unreal. Oh, Nylund threw a punch at Baudelaire. Baudelaire wasn't even watching. To get after Nylund. He's being held by Kevin Collins. He's pointing at Nylund. This is going to explode. Baudelaire was just holding off Nylund, and when Baudelaire turned to look at McCarthy and Chelios, Nylund threw a punch at Baudelaire and fortunately missed. Miller's telling Nylund he wants him. Klein waltzing with Dave Bailey. Dude, this is... I guess this was coming with a 3-3 tie in October and a 3-2 overtime game Monday night in Montreal, and another close physical game tonight. I guess it had to explode sooner or later. Well, Miller gets a ovation as he goes to the dressing room. I'm willing to wager, Fred, that we haven't seen the last of this tonight. Miller should only be getting a fighting major, as will McCarthy and Baudelaire. Nylon, Chelios, and Maley will all get 5 minutes. Nylon. Oh, Nylon took a swing at Lindsman. Here we go. Well, this will clear the benches. Here we go. Terry O'Reilly trying to hold off Mike McPhee and Patrick Roy. Portnall, who's he going with down the runway? Strudlin. This thing has spilled out into the hallway between the dressing rooms. This is unbelievable. Marquardt has Lemieux. Out. He'll say something to Lindsman as they head for the dressing room. And he'll swing at Lindsman, and that's what started it. Lindsman went after Nylon, and God knows how they made out. That one spilled out into the hallway.